Hey, it's Jamie Moore here. You're on the Off the Ball at League of Ireland podcast with you on offtheball.com every Wednesday. And I'm very happy to welcome the new manager of the Ireland women's national team to the show for the first time. She's a Dutch lady called Vera Pauw. I hope I'm pronouncing her name correctly. Capped 89 times by Netherlands, Vera was the first Dutch woman to play professionally outside of Holland when she signed for Italian side Modena in 1988. The 56-year-old is also an instructor with FIFA and UEFA and began her management career with Scotland in 1998 before she led Netherlands to the European Championship semi-finals in 2009. Since then, she's managed the national teams in Russia and South Africa and worked as an advisor to the Thailand FA as well. Pauw also coached Houston Dash for a season in the United States. And she takes over from previous manager Colin Bell and in turn caretaker boss Tom O'Connor, who led the girls in green to their opening Euro 2021 qualification win last night over Montenegro at Tala Stadium. A 2-0 win. A game I was at, the goals coming from Tyler Toland and the captain Katie McCabe. And I'm happy that Vera joins me on the phone now. Vera, welcome to the podcast. How are you?
I'm very well. Thank you so much.
So Vera, firstly, you're the new manager of the Ireland women's national team. And I know you watched the game last night in Tala. You were hiding in the corner of the stand, so we weren't able to find you or see you. So how has the last week or so worked in the last few days? Because I'm sure you've been having conversations with Ruud Dokker and the FAI, and eventually you've signed your contract and agreed to become the new women's national team manager.
Yeah, I must say I was really, really impressed by the management of FAI. How do you pronounce it? FAI.
FAI, yes, the FAI.
I need to get into everything.
Yeah, no problem.
But they really convinced me with their philosophy, with what they want to achieve with women's football, the way they progress, the steps that Ireland has made. And I've seen Ireland playing, of course, in their qualification campaign for the World Cup, and was really impressed especially when they were playing the Netherlands. So it's a team that is really halfway the ladder, and it's great to take over a team that is already so well structured by Colin and Tom, and they've done really a tremendous job in getting the team where they are now. So for me, it's really exciting because we are going to build on that. And the players, there's enough talent, there's massive talent in this team, and especially there's such a great will to make the next step. So I'm really looking forward to that.
Now, Vera, I mentioned that you're from Holland and the FAI High Performance Director, Ruud Dokker, is also Dutch. What sort of influence did he have in bringing you into this job?
His influence was especially because of the philosophy that Ireland is now using in their football. I've had many situations in which I had to convince my way of working, and we're coming from the same school. So he did not have to convince me from a technical point of view because, we have the same ideas. And when I found out that the whole coach educational system and the other coaches are working in within that philosophy, the choice was easily made because that is just so great to work in a situation where people understand each other, where people have chosen for a certain style of education, style of approaching the game, style of teaching players, and the pathway that is set for players to learn and to grow from a youth player to an international top player. And I'm really excited to be able to work into that environment because usually I have to fight for every step that I want to take. And now we will do that together.
Yeah, and I mentioned, Vera, that I spoke to the interim manager, Tom O'Connor, last night after the match, and he did give an indication that there would be an announcement today. I thought he might get the job, but clearly he hasn't. You've got the job. Is he going to be on your staff, and have you decided yet he'll be joining your coaching staff?
We did not start the discussions about that. There's one thing that I would like to mention. Everywhere I come, every country that I've coached, I've made sure that the development will go on after I leave. So my staff will be built around that. People who will, after I leave, will bring the game to the next level, take over so that people can grow during my stay, and that the structure will be consistent so that it's not falling apart, what happens in a lot of countries in women's football. Usually, I don't know yet if that's here, but usually the structure is very vulnerable. And by working in this way, in all the countries where I've worked, the next coach or next staff has always built on where we were, and the team have always grown further. The Netherlands is known after the semi-finals and being kicked out only four minutes after the end of extra time to reach the finals in the Euro 2009. The team has grown on and now we're the finalists of the World Cup. And South Africa, after reaching the Olympics, they now went to the World Cup. Scotland went on and have now reached the European Championships and is only growing and growing. So I'm very proud of leaving structures and the decisions will be made around that island. Also, Ireland will grow further when I leave. Yeah. And the personnel we've not spoken about yet.
Yeah,
we've only spoken about the principles of that.
Yeah, Vera, and I was going to ask you to give us an overview of your career in the different countries you've worked in, but you've given us quite a good one there in terms of Russia and South Africa and obviously your home country, Netherlands, and some time in America as well. What do you know, Vera, about Irish football and about this Irish team? And, you know, we've spoken in the last couple of years on our podcast here and on our programmes about the growth of women's football in Ireland, the growth of the League of Ireland and the hopes of this Ireland senior team to make their first ever major tournament. But when you're coming into the job now as a new person to the country, what do you know about Irish football?
I've been discussing Irish football in length, not only with Ruud, but also with the president and the CEO. And with Sue Ronan, we will work together on getting the team to the whole football on another level and to connect the development programs to the programs of the national teams. Initially, of course, the youth teams, and from there to the international team. So I've been diving into the structures, and of course, all the ins and outs and people I do not know yet, but the first things we're going to do is get all the coaches in. I'm going to visit all the clubs, and Sue Ronan is going to help me to dive into the history of the game, because that is really important to make the right decisions at the right moments, and we'll grow from there. But that is the way that I always do, and the history and the culture of a country is for me the starting point of working.
Yeah, and of course, Vera mentioned there, Sue Ronan, former Ireland Women's National Team manager herself and head of women's football in the FAI as well. And Vera, you were at the match last night, a victory for the girls in green, early goal and then a late goal or a penalty from Katie McKay with 20 minutes left. Now, Montenegro had lost 10-0 to Germany at the weekend, so we were hopeful for a big Irish scoreline, but the girls, we spoke to Louise Quinn and Katie McCabe afterwards, and they said, you know, they wanted to win the game and keep a clean sheet and get the 3 points, and that's what they did. You watched the game from the stands. What did you make of your new team in action?
And they are very, very talented, and they can only grow from here. The key point in this situation was to get the 3 points, and the whole staff and players have done tremendously and prepared so professionally for this game. And I mean, it's tremendous to start off with 3 points, and from there we're going to build. I'm going to analyze the game and analyze the players, talk a lot about the people who know them more, and from there we will build.
Yeah, I was actually over in Abbottstown just interviewing Mick McCarthy and Seamus Coleman and watching the senior men's team train, Vera, when the press release came out to say that you were the new manager. And one quote was, "I'm very excited at the prospect of managing the Republic of Ireland women's national team for the remainder of this European Championship campaign. And I believe we can achieve very positive results together." And Ireland have never made a major European Championships or a World Cup, Vera, in their time in international women's football, and almost made the playoffs in the last World Cup campaign under Colin Bell. And we saw how fantastic the Women's World Cup was over the summer. So your ambition, and I'm sure your job spec, has to be to try and bring the girls to one of these tournaments in the coming years.
Yeah, of course, that's the main aim. And what I said, Colin and Tom have done a tremendous job with the team. So we're really starting with where we are now, and we're not going to turn everything upside down, because why would you do that when a team is on the development in such a great way? So that's the situation at this moment. And I had already a meeting with the key players. Already meetings with Rudoktor, of course, and with management. Sue Ronan and I will speak this afternoon. And from there, we are going to make quick decisions because the Ukraine game is on the doorstep. It's only 3 weeks from now that we have to camp again. And that is immediately the key game in the whole campaign because it's Ukraine home. And you need to get a positive result in those games of Ukraine. So it's either a draw and a win or two wins. But we need to get to take over Ukraine. And then we can see what we can do against Germany.
Yeah, myself and Vera as well, speaking on Wednesday afternoon before her first press conference. So thanks to the FBI for giving us access to Vera on the phone before she actually meets the rest of the media for the first time. And Vera, just our last couple of questions. I appreciate you've got lots to do this afternoon. There's been lots of stuff involving the FAI in recent times off the pitch and lots of negative headlines, Vera. But on the pitch, the men's national team, the women's team, the underage teams, about men's and women's, have been doing very, very well. But the fact that there has been lots of stories away from football, was that ever in your head in terms of making your decision to come? Or, you know, just because the football is quite good at the moment, was that the only thing you were thinking about? Because the FAI has been in a bit of a storm over the last while.
The reason why I decided to sign to come is because the management was extremely honest about the situation of the association at this moment and about the state of Irish football, Irish women's football, and where improvement needs to be made and why they wanted me to lead the process for the international team. And so they did not make it any better than it is. They were very open and showed me what was happening in the within the association and around the association. And that actually built the trust for me to step into it.
And Vera, of course, your job is to manage the women's national team, but I'm sure it's also to develop women's football in the country. And, you know, we've seen in recent years the growth of women's sport in Ireland and in the world, really. And, you know, last night at the game, over 4,000 fans there again. And I love after the games when the players take time to stand, you know, at the side of the pitch and take selfies and take autographs and speak to the young girls. And I left the stadium last night, maybe around 10:45, having done the media, and there were still maybe 15 or 20 young girls with their parents standing in the car park in the dark, waiting to meet the players and get their autographs and get some photos. And that's I got a real sense of what football means to those young girls. I know it means a lot to you as well. You've worked in this game for a long time, and I'm sure that's something you're excited about as well, to bring hopefully a successful Irish team to Tallaght Stadium for these young girls and boys and their parents and the wider football public to cheer you on.
Of course, that's the ultimate that you can reach, that the little girls are excited to see their heroes, the heroines, and to get close to them. And I think that is the big difference between men's football and women's football, is that the female players are always available for the young girls. And whatever it takes, the time that it takes, it doesn't matter. Female players are always there because they feel the responsibility for the future stars and to inspire little girls to enjoy football and to enjoy being in sport and being in the structures of sport. So I will give always the space for fans, for especially the little girls. You cannot have enough of them in the stands, and it was exciting to see the numbers that came out last night, and especially not only the numbers but the atmosphere around the game. It was just amazing to feel.
And Vera, lastly, you've lived in lots of places around the world. You're from Holland, you've obviously lived there, you've lived as well when you managed Scotland, also Russia, South Africa. You've done some work for the Thailand FA, spending some time there too, and you've lived in America, and now you're moving to Ireland. So you've lived in lots of places around the world. You've only just landed this afternoon, but I'm not sure if you've been to this country before. But what do you expect from living here? You know, you're going to have to move here. You're going to work for the FAIHU in Abbottstown and live here in Dublin.
I expect a lot of rain and a lot of wind.
Yes. I'm sorry about that.
That's part of Ireland, and I'm used to that for the years that I was working in Scotland, and it never, ever bothered me. So I'm looking forward to the beautiful sceneries that I found on internet. I visited Ireland many times, but always related to football. So I've not seen much of the country, but I really plan to do so, because what I've seen on the internet, it's just an amazing scenery, and I will really look forward to go there.
Great stuff. Vera Pauw, is it Pauw? Am I pronouncing that correctly, Vera?
It's actually Pauw.
Pauw, Vera Pauw. Okay,
no,
I should have asked you that at the start. So I will tell all of our journalists here on Off the Ball, it's Vera Pauw, the new Ireland Women's National Team Manager. Vera, thank you so much for your time. Enjoy your press conference this afternoon, and the best
thank
of luck. We'll
you.
See you at your first game in a few weeks' time at Tallaght Stadium against Ukraine. Thanks a million, Vera.
Thank you, and thank you for having me in your show.
Cheers. Thanks very much.